Happy New Year, fellow wet shavers. How is everybody doing today? Be right back. Nomeo Shaves here with another shaving video. This is January 1st. Now, when you see this video, it'll probably be January 2nd. That's just how I roll. Anyways, I hope you all had a fantastic New Year's. I hope you all had a safe New Year's. Hope you're all not hungover. Knock on wood, I'm not hungover. I didn't really drink too much, so it was good. It ended up really, really awesome night. Me and the family went out to Treasure Island in San Francisco just to watch the fireworks display. Yes, I'm out of focus. I do feel like I'm coming down with something as well. I'm hoping not. Hoping it's just like the cold crud, you know, and stuff like that, because I have a trip I'm supposed to be going on next weekend. Netherlands. All right, let me get into today's shave. I was really having a hard time deciding what soap to use. So I thought, you know what? New year, new soap. I'm going with a soap base brand that I have never, ever tried before. And I have heard nothing but fantastic things about them. And their customer service is freaking outstanding. Declaration Grooming's Sellout. This is their Icarus formula. And this is based off Creed Aventus. And I gotta tell you, it's nice. It's more on the cologne side. So I've tried Sterling's Executive Man. I had tried a sample of Emperor from Razor Rock and Spartacus. And those are the only, or A&E Spartacus, excuse me. Those are the only Aventus scents that I've tried. I like Executive Man and this one. These two are just, there's something different about them. One thing I do like about this Declaration Grooming version, it's strong. It's very nice strong, maybe 6 or 7 off the puck. It's beautiful. Now, when I first got it, let me start going into my shave here. I'll go back. I don't want to ramble on and just talk about nothing before I get my shave started. Going with Common Sword today, I almost went with the Fat Boy for a Fat Boy, but you know, I need to use this to really test this soap out. Wolf Whiskers and Brand New Feather Professional. I don't know if you guys can hear that in the background, but we found a new TV show to start watching. It's a Netflix show called The House, The Haunting of Hill House. Holy crap, that's freaking awesome. All right, I've got this blooming. I'm gonna go ahead and put the bloom water in my face. And then I'll kind of talk a little bit more about this. Hold on. Gosh, it's a nice scent. Beautiful. Since it is cold, I'm going to make my brush nice and warm. And then I'll just rinse with cold water. Right, now, I'm just going to go ahead and go into the puck here. The thing about the soap, when I first got it, it was really gamey smelling. You could really smell the tallow. And it wasn't where you can just barely smell it. It was actually pretty even with the scent strength of the soap. But you know, I've had this for 2-3 weeks, maybe 3 weeks now, and it's tallow smell's gone. It's a very nice strong cologne type smell. Creed Aventus for sure. It's beautiful. Now the reason why I'm just using it now is so this went on sale on Black Friday and I bought it. You know, they had a great deal, they had free shipping plus a discount on it. Look at this. And package apparently never made it to the UPS or USPS. So they had to wait like 2 weeks before they can claim it lost. So it was claim lost. Then he sent out another one. The second package showed up at my doorstep. It was an empty box. Oh, I was so mad. Scott was just freaking awesome to deal with. This stuff is already starting to lather. You know, he sent out a third one. He contacted Maggard's and had it sent by from them, and it got here no problem. So Scott, if you ever watch this video, I appreciate what you did, man. That's top-notch customer service. Top freaking notch. Based on that alone, this will not be my first time that I buy from him. I doubt I'll ever be able to afford one of his brushes, but you never know. His brushes are beautiful, though, man. Holy crap. All right, rinse back puck off. I know some people don't, but I do. I like to. So I'll show you the color really quick. It's a brown color. Now this is, it's got, you guys are familiar with decoration grooming, right? I mean, it's got the bison tallow, sheep milk and goat milk, I think, or whatever. Lanolin and goat milk. Yeah. Lamb tallow too. It's good stuff. You guys, I'm like really good at telling you guys what the hell's in these soaps, right? So if you really want to know, go to Decoration Groomy's website and check it out. Oh my god. I think I have way too much. Okay. But yeah, so customer service was just freaking amazing. Unfortunately, it took me a while to get this, you know. It took me probably a month before I was able to get it from the time I originally ordered it. But Scott was just freaking awesome. So just based on that experience alone, even though, you know, it took me a while to get my first shipment, just based on the customer service and stuff, I'll definitely buy it again. For sure. But yeah, and trying to figure out what soap to use, you know, I thought about just going with the Sterling, kind of reset myself, you know, and use a Fat Boy. But, you know, I was chatting with another buddy this morning a little bit. And I thought, you know what, maybe since it's a new year, I'll do a new soap. Man, this stuff is just lathering up incredible. Beautiful lather. No effort. Zero effort. Look at this. Beautiful. Right. So you guys saw that I put a blade in here. Oop. First pass with the grain. Now. Oh yeah, it's, you don't need me to tell you how good this stuff is. This is pretty really good. This is, it's a nice soap. I can even add more water. So, with it being the new year, typically everybody's new year's resolution is to lose weight, right? Well, I'm still trying to lose my Christmas weight. Yeah, I put a couple more pounds on the past couple days. Figured, you know, it's New Year. Screw it. Enjoy it. Oh, yeah, I got a few weepers. That's my fault. In a rush. But if you don't know, January is World Carnivore Month, and I'm participating. So that's basically 30 days of just meat and water. Now, unfortunately, my daughter's birthday is this month. So, I'm already anticipating one day where I may not be able to follow it 100%. Something I'm also going to try working on this year is doing like extended fasts. Now I'm typically a one meal a day person. It works great with my schedule. It works great if you're trying to lose some weight. Think about losing weight though. It's a commitment. You know, we all say, okay, I'm going to do it this year. I'm going to do it. But you have to remember that no matter what diet you choose, I mean, it's got to be one that you're going to stick to, number one. You know, you can try them all. You know, maybe you'll last 6 weeks on one and maybe, you know, 6 months on another. It really is a trial and error, and you gotta stick with it. But the one thing you have to keep in mind, it's gonna suck. It's gonna be uncomfortable. You gotta really embrace it and get out of that comfort zone. I think that's one problem as humans, is we get too comfortable and we don't want to break out of that. When you break out of that comfort zone, that's when you start to really improve and make big changes. Residual sickness is really nice. Real nice. Beautiful scent. It's staying about a 5-6 easily. Oh, that's a thirsty soap. Watch this. Very nice. Okay. My nose is a little bit raw from the blowing of the nose today. All right. Cross grain. Ear to nose. You know, like one thing about being, what I said about being uncomfortable, right? My wife does not like the cold. Oh my gosh. Last night. It's only 50. I know they're from the Philippines, so their version of cold is a lot different than mine. It's beautiful. There's nothing I can't say about the soap that's already been said. It's good. These weepers are my fault, not the soap. I always get quite a bit of weepers when I go to a new feather. It doesn't happen when I go with the Kai though. Not this bad. They are sharp though. I prefer the Kais. Your mileage may vary. Beautiful. Beautiful. Just a little bit here. I can't wait to do the face wash with this one. Just a quick little cleanup right here. Really good. We'll call that done. Yeah. Greek yogurt. Not too bad. That was a pimple. Okay. Maybe they weren't weepers. Maybe they're pimples. All right. I got the splash too. It's nighttime. I don't care. My wife will like this one. See what the burn is like. Ooh, that feels nice. Is there a menthol in that? feel something right in here. Witch hazel, water, alcohol, glycerin fragrance, menthol. Sweet, sweet. I didn't even know that. That was awesome. That was a nice little kick. All right, everybody, that's my shave. I hope you enjoyed it. That was good. Now, oh, I'm going to have to close these up. Damn it. After. Well, let me do a quick little recap. Declaration Grooming's Icarus Base Sellout. This is their version of Creed Aventus. It's good. If you like the more cologne-y scents, this is for you. Whereas, like, Spartacus tend to be... I smell more like the green apple out of it. Sterling's is beautiful, but it's a little bit on the light side. This is nice and potent and strong. So I think you'd like it. Well, now, once again, January is World Carnivore Month. I'm going to be following it, except for probably one, maybe 2 days. And that's because of my daughter's birthday. If you guys have some questions about it, hit me up. But remember, you know, when you take that step to lose weight, you can't do it for anybody else. You have to do it for you. And it's really a lifestyle change because you can't go back to those old eating habits. You know, once you change your eating habits, you have to stick with them for life. Otherwise, your old habits, you're going to put your old weight back on, right? It's just the reality of the game, and it sucks. Losing weight sucks ass. It's hard. You're going to be miserable. People aren't going to like you. But you know what? You're bettering yourself. Stick with it. All right. That's all for tonight, everybody. Until next time, hopefully I'll be able to get one more in before I travel. And until then, Happy New Year, everybody. Stay safe out there. Stay warm if you're in a place where you get a lot of snow. I hope you're staying warm anyways. And until next time, please do not text and drive. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye and Happy New Year.